Okay, so now we're getting to, again, gun defense from the front, but now we're adding a little bit of a worst case situation. So it doesn't matter if he's grabbing me or holding me, it doesn't matter. This is not the problem at the moment. There's a gun in the hand, it's got the finger on the trigger that will shoot everyone and me. So now we're not talking about a gun static. So in the previous video you saw of the gun being static, this is where you need to understand where reality comes in. This gun will not be static forever. It's not something like he's putting it there and then he's asking for my money until it doesn't work like that. Maybe this is a 2-second window. That is gun defense static. Gun defense moving is when it's never static. It's not arriving for me to have a situation where I can physically get my hands on the gun. Because believe it or not, the situation, if he's moving the gun just a little bit, even from this distance, to grab this is, it's bullshit, to be honest. It's not gonna work in reality. So when we deal with this situation, we want to close the distance, not for the pulling to happen, number one, of course. And number two, this bullet that's gonna come out, I don't want this to arrive anywhere close to my face. Not even in my face, not even somewhere close to my face. So I need to make sure that I move forward out of the line of fire. So I'll use my arm and I'll use, of course, my body. I'm not relying on him to move. I'm not moving just the gun and expecting him to move. I'm moving myself, always. So, of course, submit as much as you can. Get your hands up where you can protect yourself, not for this gun to smash your face off. I protect myself as much as I can. He's moving the gun because he wants something. I want to move forward out of the line of fire. And when I see my opportunity to move the gun and move myself in, again, arriving under the arm and over the arm with the other hand. Again, moving in and shifting so that this gun doesn't manipulate to my body when I have the control. Okay, yes, your kicks, yes, this and that. Always think worst case scenario. So again, then from the position where you're in your control, I need to understand that I'm dealing with a mindset, which is the problem. I'll secure the gun and start to fight. And try not to take this arm out to give damage and because I'm dealing with a hot weapon. I want to keep my hand in as much as I can to secure the pulling. Damage, headbutt, and again, taking down, rotating in my same control that I was. Moving can do damage, but better for you just to quickly move, take the gun in when it's out and use it to control the situation as best possible. Okay, let's see that when you understand when the gun is moving, it's not something very easy to deal with. You need to wait for your opportunity. So we'll see this full speed.
Where's your fucking hand?
I don't have my number.
Okay, show me your pocket. Empty your pocket, I'll blow your fucking door, man.
Okay.
I can't take it. Fucking shoot you, motherfucker.
I understand.
Come on, show me your fucking
hand. Yes! Drop the gun. Stand up!
On your face. Yeah. Color system, God bless you.